Huh? For ya. Oh, bit of fun that, wasn't it, really? So yeah, I'm gonna make things flow. Come on. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video here on the channel. My name is Nathan, and welcome to Better Media. I'm back in my shed. I did sort of plan to do this outside, but it's such a good day. I couldn't actually record this in direct sunlight. Plus, for what I want to do today, it's just a little bit too much wind outside. So what I am planning to do is, I don't know if you guys saw it a few months ago or a few weeks ago or however long ago it was, it's that I did a tutorial on how to float yourself in a photograph. If you've not watched that, I'll stick a little card just up here for you so you can have a quick little look at it, or if not, you can go over to the channel and find it. So yeah, take your time, go and watch that. Maybe you can watch that now and come back, it's entirely up to you. But this time, I'm gonna see if I can float some objects. Quite simply, I've went around my house, I've found a few objects which I think would look pretty cool to float. Some might work out, some might not. Like we saw last week when I was throwing things in a fish tank, some things just didn't work as well as I thought it was going to. Now for this, I've set up my my frame, we'll show that in a second. And these are the objects that I plan to sort of float. So of course, we've got the lemon, which I showed you in the first bit. So I'm gonna see if I can sort of maybe chop that up and have it sort of like floating in two different parts. We'll see how well that goes. I've got a pair of sunnies just here. Sunglasses have come back from last week. Hopefully I might be able to do a better job at that than I did in the previous video. Got a cup. Nice little cup, I think that'd be pretty cool. Maybe put some liquid in it as well to sort of maybe float there and give that a go. The Pioneer Cam is back because, quite frankly, I've bought it and I can't quite use it in anything extraordinary yet. So it's become a bit of a feature. But I have got my son's little robot bot toy. I'm gonna see if I can get that floaty in a nice little way as well. And of course, got some string so I can hang things up. I don't know if it's the best type of string, it's quite thick. So it might be a bit of a challenge to edit that out. But at the end of the road, we can only try these things, can't we? We're stuck inside, sort of getting ready to go outside, but right now, not really doing much. So give that a go. I've got some tape, I've got some scissors to give it a crack as well. So those are my objects. So 5 objects. Let's see if we can find the sixth one. Pretty sure I had six, but 5 for now. So come and have a quick look over at what I'm gonna dangle it on, just over here. Right, so I do have a sixth object. It's actually a cork, just found in my pocket. So that's what I'm gonna also try to do as well, give that a float as well. And this is my setup. So the setup is quite simply, it's my backdrop frame. It's usually what I hang my green screen on or any of the backdrops that I use within my photography or film work. It's pretty good because not only does it have a nice wide space so I can dangle things in the middle of it, so I can also adjust the height with it as well. Quite simply like that. So I can adjust the height, so I can have it quite high up and I can stand up, or I can bring it like down, I can get down a little bit. So I think in general, it should work out quite well. Also, it does mean that I can get quite close or quite far with the camera itself and still not have the frame in shot, which is the plan behind that. So I think we're gonna start off with the sunglasses again this week, see if we can do any better results than what we did last time. So, let's get set up.
Well, down here in Nola on Fowler Street, when you reach Magnolia, halt your feet at this little store should hurry along real soon.
Okay, cool. So I'm happy with the setup now. So I'm gonna quickly do a few shots. I've got the shutter from my phone. So I'm gonna use my phone as my remote shutter. So that way I don't need to be close to the camera and run around. That way it can also help with the focus also. And I've also got it on a 10 second timer as well. So when I press the shutter, I've got 10 seconds to get myself into position, make sure the frame is right before the photograph goes off. So that's the plan with that. Okay, so let's get the first round going. So those are sunglasses done. I'm quite okay with some of the photographs because I don't know what they're gonna look like until I've put them into Photoshop or Lightroom. But yeah, I've got about 10, maybe 12 nice photographs. Like the sunglasses are all in focus. Something that I've noticed as well that I might have to do every now and then is that get the object into focus using the autofocus that I have in the lens, in the camera. And then going around, clicking it onto manual to keep it at that focal point. So when I come around, it doesn't sort of try to pick me up in the frame. So I've had to flip between those two type of things. So yeah, it's good. I like finding challenges like this because it's fun, you know, it's fun. So we're gonna move on to our next object. I think I might give the cup a go. That'd be quite nice. Get the cup, should we give the cup, should we go? You can't tell me. I don't know, like if you've got time, maybe comment what you want me to do, but at the end of the day, you've not seen the film yet. So you don't know. I'm gonna do the cup next.
She makes gumbo, put hair on your chest. Her Creole crawfish are the best. You'll be hooked on for life if you taste a single spoon.
Okay, so the cup is ready, it's up in position, it's got like a nice little height. I've risen the upper bar a little bit, so it's just a little bit above my head. So it's like it's a nice little mid-length or midway through where I am, so I can have like a nice little grr thing. Obviously, that's facing the wrong way, so I don't know how that's gonna work. Because you can see the tape. Don't wanna see the tape, do you? You wanna be that way around. Like that. There we go. Might even have some water in it. Might not, you might not even see it, so it might not even matter. That might put some weight to the bottom, actually, could help. So I'm gonna give this one a crack now.
Hey there, baby, sweet as can be. For your love, I beg, borrow, or steal. Beg, borrow, or steal. Beg, borrow, or steal. For a love like yours, I beg, borrow, or steal.
So that's the cup done. Move on to the next object. I'm gonna speed this little process up a little bit now, because you don't need to see me sort of do each object individually. But yeah, next object. Don't know what it's gonna be. Gonna be the robot now. I think the robot.
Yeah.
Right, so that came up with a couple of challenges that I didn't expect. The robot itself was just too heavy for the tape, so I've had to sort of adapt it slightly, a little bit. So what I've done is that I've got it on the floor, just down here, and I'm planning sort of like it's running away from it. It's got wheels, so I think it'll look pretty cool. So we're gonna be quite low, shoot from down there, and look like I'm trying to chase after a robot that's just gone rogue. That's the plan anyway. Cool. That little red dress, them stiletto heels, make me wanna know how your loving feels. Make borrow or steal, make borrow or steal, for a love like yours. Make borrow or steal. Baby, you didn't hear me, baby. Okay, so some of these are starting to look really good on camera now, actually. The robot was a little bit of an issue, as I said before. It kept sort of swinging a little bit, so you can see the undersides. I had to take a few, try to get in the right position, in the right place. That's what I needed to do. But some of them on camera are looking really, really cool now. So I'm gonna quickly bust through. I'm gonna do the lemon now. I'm gonna try something a little bit funky with the lemon. I'm gonna try a cut in half and see if I can get it sort of like two sides of it sort of floating a little bit like that. So that's gonna be a bit more of a challenge. And then just simply after that, we've got the camera, and I think I've lost the cork. The cork's around here somewhere, so we'll try to do the camera and the cork as well. But yeah, let's chop up a lemon. Big bottle of steel. Okay, cool. So those are my objects. I've still got the camera to do, but I'm gonna wrap this little bit up now. I'm gonna do the camera in a little while because it's getting quite late. I'm gonna go have some lunch and I'm gonna quickly buzz through doing the camera and see if I can find a cork as well. See if I can do anything cool with the cork. But apart from that, guys, these are what I've managed to come up with. I've still got to edit them. I've not taken them away yet. I'm still making the video. So hopefully they've come out quite well. I'm pretty sure they have done. I've got some really, really cool shots within camera. And it was a lot of fun. I went into Photoshop, got rid of the string, and then I put them into Lightroom and gave them a nice little bit of an edit. And, you know, something like this is challenging. That's the whole point of doing sort of like the art of photography, I guess, is to try to find new things. And I'm quite grateful for the lockdown itself. It's managed to sort of bring more of a challenge to me as a photographer, as a filmmaker as well, to try to sort of like think a little bit outside the box. Instead of just going into town and shooting and taking pictures of nice people and places and buildings, I've faced my fears of Photoshop, and I've gone into Photoshop and I've had a bit of play in there, and I've done things like this. I've had to have a think of what I can do with my surroundings, which is a lot like the photographers that I follow online anyway. I've always kept myself in a nice little safe box where I know what I'm doing. I know how to do headshots. I know how to do portraits. I know what looks nice within the city because it's already there. But something like this, when I've had to sort of to go around my house, find something that looks pretty and see what can I do with that. And it's been quite a nice little challenge. I've quite enjoyed it. I hope you've enjoyed this with me. If you want to know how I've made these objects float, with the way that I edit them, drop down into the comments and let me know, and I'll make a tutorial on how I actually made these object floats. It's quite self-explanatory, but if you'd like me to show you, like me to teach you, I'd be more than happy to do so. While you're down there, how about give it a go and hit the subscribe button and the thumbs up? It means a lot to me. It really, really does help, and you can be just all part of the Benham Media family. Don't forget, if you are interested in anything else that we do, I have my social media tags floating just down here. You can see the results of these photographs and other things that I have done throughout lockdown and also throughout my career as well. So guys, thank you so much for joining me on this adventure. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've enjoyed making it. Until next time, I've been Nathan. You've been sensational. Goodbye and thank you. Mwah, 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 mwah. Brother, it's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.